Dear student, now I give lecture on SCADA. What is mean by SCADA? SCADA is nothing but Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition System. SCADA refers to a system that collects data from various sensors at a factory, plant or in other remote location and then sends this data to a central computer which then manages and controls the data. SCADA systems are used not only in industrial processes but also in some experimental facilities such as nuclear fusion. What is the definition of SCADA? A collection of equipment that will provide an operator at a remote location with enough information to determine the status of a particular piece of equipment or entire substation and cause actions to take place regarding the equipment or network. This is the definition of SCADA. Then we studied about the SCADA components. Now you see the diagram. This diagram represents the functional units of simple SCADA system with a single computer. The simple SCADA system with a single computer consists of program, input-output equipment, auxiliary memories, CPU, remote terminal units, that is RTU, communication interface, and a display and control console. These are the main functional units of simple SCADA system with a single computer. Now, we studied about the function of simple SCADA system. The simple SCADA system represents the simplest configuration of the SCADA with a single computer. The computer received data from remote terminal units through the communication interface. One or more CRT terminals for display is controlled by operators. With this system, it is possible to execute supervisory control commands and request the display of data in alphanumerical format. The input-output SCADA programming is used to change the supervisory software. In the basic SCADA system, all the data and programs are stored in the main memory. The more complicated version of the SCADA has additional secondary memories in the form of magnetic disk units. Then we studied about the uses of power system SCADA. What are the uses? Electric power generation, transmission and distribution. The SCADA systems are used in electric power generation, transmission and distribution. What is the function of SCADA? The SCADA system is used to detect the current flow and line voltage to monitor the operation of circuit breakers and to take sections of the power grid online or offline. Second one is water and sewage. These are the second uses of power system SCADA. In these uses, the state and municipal water utilities use SCADA to monitor and regulate water flow, reservoir levels, pipe pressure and other factors. Third one is buildings, facilities and the environments. Facility managers use SCADA to control HVAC, refrigeration units, lighting and the entry systems. Then manufacturing. The manufacturing uses SCADA system manage parts inventories for just-in-time manufacturing, regulate industrial automation and robots, and monitor process and quality control. Then MOS transist and traffic signal. In MOS transist, the transist authorities use SCADA to regulate electricity to subways, trams, trolley buses, to automate traffic signals for rail system, to track and locate trains and buses, and to control railroad crossing gates. Traffic signals. In traffic signals, SCADA regulates traffic lights, controls traffic flow and detects out of order signals. Then remote terminal unit of the power system SCADA. A remote terminal unit is a microprocessor controlled electronic device that interfaces objects in the physical world to a distributed control system or SCADA system by transmitting telemetry data to a master system and by using messages from the master supervisory system to control connected objects. The remote terminal unit or remote telemetry unit or remote telecontrol unit. The architecture of the remote terminal unit is an RTU monitors the field digital and analog parameters and transmits data to the central monitoring station. It contains set of software to connect data input stream to the data output stream, define communication protocols and troubleshoot installation problems. The remote terminal unit consists of one complex circuit card consisting of various sections needed to do a custom fitted function or may consist of many circuit cards including CPU or processing with the communications interface and one or more of the following, that is analog input, digital input, digital output or control relay output or analog output cards. Then power supply. The power supply will be included for operation from the AC main for various CPU status, winding voltages and other interfaces cards. The power supply mainly consists of AC to DC converters were operated from a station battery system. Then third one is digital inputs. Most RTUs incorporate an input section or input status cards to acquire two state real world information. That is, digital means either 0 or 1. This is usually accomplished by using an isolated voltage or current source to sense the position of a remote contact, that is open or closed at the RTU site. This contact position may represent many different devices including electrical breakers, liquid wall positions, alarm conditions and mechanical positions of devices. The counter inputs are optional only. The next, analog inputs. The analog inputs of different types including 0 to 1 milliamps, 4 to 20 milliamps current loop only. Many RTU inputs buffer larger quantity via transducers to convert and isolate real world quantities from sensitive RTU input levels. The RTU can receive analog data via communication system from a master or intelligent electronic device, that is IED, sending data values to it. The RTU translates and scales this raw data into the appropriate units such as quantity of water left or temperature degrees or megawatt hours etc. before presenting the data to the user via the human machine interface. Then digital control relay output. The RTU may drive high current capacity relays to a digital output board to switch power on or off to devices in the field. The digital output switches The digital output board switches voltage to the coil in the relay, which closes the high current contacts, which completes the power circuit to the device. The RTU outputs consist of driving a sensitive logic input of an electronic PLC or other electronic device using a sensitive 5 volt input, then analog inputs. Analog outputs may be included to control devices that require varying quantities, such as graphic recording instruments. Then, software and logic control. Modern RTU are usually capable of executing simple programs autonomously without involving the host computers of the DCS or SCADA system to simplify deployment and to provide redundancy for safety reasons. In a modern water management system, the RTU will typically have code to modify its behavior when physical override switches on the RTU are toggled during maintenance by a maintenance personnel. Then the last one is communications. A RTU may be interfaced to multiple master stations and intelligent electronic device is nothing but IEDs with a different communication media, usually serial RS-232 or RS-485, RS-422 or Ethernet. Thank you, student, for watching this video.